Murray saying they feel like second-class citizens, or if you expect him to follow more the Donald Trump model and continue appealing largely to his base.
Well, you know, the reason I concluded with that quote from the Prime Minister, which is just, he just made that statement, it's a very significant statement. He says, together we will build a strong and inclusive India. Inclusive is when you want to take everybody with you. He is the Prime Minister of India. He's not just taking care of the interests of those who voted for him, the 55% to, or 45% who voted for him. We're talking about the fact that every Indian is a citizen that commands his attention. So that he has made clear that that we will be looking at an India that will try and take everybody with us. I must say here that you know, the nature of our constitution, the system that we have in India itself is conducive to an inclusive involvement of all in India's growth and development. And the fact that the BJP has increased its political support across the country in areas which might have ethnic minorities, might have religious minorities, might have other groups, as I told you, it has not been a divisive election. It has been an election that have united the people of India. The northeastern part of India, which is predominantly Christian, somewhat geographically you know, distant from the mainland, has also voted primarily for the ruling party. Nobody could imagine that in a state like Mizoram, a state like Nagaland, which are, I think, almost 100% have Christian population, vote for the BJP. If you talk about a Hindu nationalist party, then you won't have a Christian population voting for Hindus. I think that's very significant. You have large Muslim population that are voting for the BJP because they see their best interests represented in the BJP. They don't want to fritter away their votes on parties that have not given them the sort of growth and development opportunities and also stability and peace that they're looking for. You look at Bengal, which is a state which has also a significant minority population, has also voted overwhelmingly, has voted very strongly in favor of the BJP. I think the BJP had no seats, if I'm not mistaken, in Bengal, and is now looking at almost half the seats in the Lok Sabha from that state. So I think it is really a vote of confidence for the, by the people of India, irrespective of the religious denomination they belong to. And I think the Prime Minister's intention is to carry all Indians with him, irrespective of their region, linguistic affiliations, caste or religion. The idea is that we are a diverse, heterogeneous population. Diversity is a very integral part of our country, whether it is states, whether it is languages, whether it is religions, whether it's cultures, we are diverse. And in that diversity, we have unity. And that is, I think, the message that the Prime Minister is trying to convey in terms of inclusivity, trying to take everybody with the agenda of growth and development, peace and stability. An India that is resurgent, an India that is looking forward, a young India that is buoyant and not encumbered by the traditional divisions that I mentioned in terms of the strategic voting that the younger people particularly have in India.
Are there any members